My name is Kimberly Chancellor. I'm a recent graduate of Texas A&M University with a Bachelor of Science in Anthropology, and am working in the Preservation Research and Testing Division.
My name is Heidi Vance, and I'm a graduate student at Northumbria University, earning my master's degree in conservation of works of art on paper. This summer, we've been working in the Preservation Research and Testing Division of the Library of Congress, assisting with the ongoing project of assessing the physical condition of the National Book Collection. During our time at the Library of Congress, we reviewed multiple sets of books from the late 19th century, each set of books containing five of what should be identical copies, all sourced from five institutions in different regions of the U.S. Our task was to review the data collected by the PRTD that was collected via analytical testing, and not only compare the data across all samples, but search for trends present in books to establish a clearer baseline for the acceptable condition of books from this era. The data we compared was collected through invasive and non-invasive testing carried out on each book. Invasive testing involves taking a sample from the book that will undergo changes and likely destruction during testing, while non-invasive testing does not.
Fiber optics reflectance spectroscopy, or FORS, and Fourier transform infrared spectroscopy, or FTIR, are non-invasive techniques often used to identify colors and materials. In these tests, a bright white or infrared light is directed at an item. Different materials cause light to bounce back in different ways, resulting in a unique pattern within the spectroscopy. Rag, newsprint, and wood pulp paper samples all appear distinct, allowing for the primary component to be identified. Paper is often treated with sizing to help ink and pigments sit on top of the paper fibers rather than absorbing into them or bleeding. Paper is also commonly created using fillers, such as clay, to cut costs or result in a smoother feeling product. Depending on the materials used, both sizing and fillers can be identified. FORS is also unique in that it creates objective color data that is more reliable to analyze than subjective views. The first set of books we examined yielded relatively identical data, providing a baseline so Heidi and I can more readily identify future anomalies. Set two had more interesting test results than set one. Multiple samples were taken from the books at different pages. The data appeared normal at first, but values within the same book differed more than between copies. Looking back at the FORS and FTIR results, it became apparent that there were two different paper types. The text block shows bands of light and dark paper, further confirming our analysis. This demonstrates the visual effects of degradation on paper with different chemical properties that experience the exact same environmental factors within their lifetime. Understanding which components correlate with paper deterioration can lead to new standards of care for library collection materials.
Two invasive techniques that are used to determine paper strength are the double fold test and tensile testing. Both tests work by destroying a small sample of the book's paper by testing the physical durability and stress that it's able to withstand. The double fold test is a traditional library stack test. A sample of paper is folded at an angle on one side, then the other. This is repeated until it breaks to test the folding endurance. While this test is widely performed, it is unreliable as the results vary significantly depending on a multitude of factors that can influence the outcome. One of the goals of the ANC project is to provide institutions with better stack tests that are more accurate and reliable. For tensile testing, a pulling force is applied to the sample until it breaks to test the sample's response to stress and the ability to be elongated. Additionally, using this technique gives us the ability to determine if the paper is stronger horizontally or vertically, which is dependent on the way the paper was made during its production. In the cases sets one and three, we're able to see very different results. In the case of our baseline set, which was set one, our tensile test results show the paper in each book tended to be stronger horizontally than vertically. And with the exception of one book, the double fold number was 10. In set three, we have a set of six books, two being from the same library. The tensile test results show a mixture of strength on the horizontal and vertical alignments. However, with the double fold test, each book has a fold result of 2. In short, even though these books are supposed to be identical, we're finding that this is not the case. However, this information is extremely helpful in conveying the amount of consideration and care each collection requires.
Working with the Preservation Division this summer has been an incredible experience. I have learned about the physical, chemical, and biological factors of paper preservation and have thoroughly enjoyed everything the Library of Congress has to offer.
Being a part of the 2021 Junior Fellows Program has been a life-changing experience. In the short time we've had here, I feel like I've learned a great deal of information and new skills. I'm so thankful for this opportunity and for being able to be a part of the Preservation Research and Testing Division.